Wait, Dimitri, are you telling me you can actually do recurring tasks in Coda without needing a third-party app? Yeah, that's another thing on the list that Coda has that Notion doesn't. Feels bad. Let's show you how to do it. So I'm just making a blank doc here, and I'm gonna call it recurring tasks. And just as an aside, Productive Dude did showcase how to do this on his YouTube channel as well. If you wanna check that out, he made a really nice video on it, and I give him credit for showing the solution on this. Okay, so what you're gonna wanna do here is first make a new table. And I'm gonna call this guy tasks, name this task, then we can have a details column here. It's just another text column. And then third, what we're gonna have is recurrence. So what this is gonna be is basically showing how often we're gonna have different things, like is it gonna be monthly, is it gonna be weekly? Okay, so we can go here, change it to a select list. And then what we're gonna type here is monthly, weekly, yearly, and we can even do daily if we wanted as well. Then we're going to change the name of this to recurrence. Then we can select one of these for each. I'm going to name these example task one, example task two, example task three. And then let's set a due date for this. So going into here, we can go and press date. And then let's make a due date for this for today and tomorrow. Actually, let's just do the same day and we'll showcase the three different functionalities that would happen if it would change. Then we can make another select list here and go new and put complete, incomplete. And we can change the name of this to status. And we can add another column, date, and change this name to next due date. Drag this guy over here. And then what we're gonna do is add a formula to this next due date. We're gonna type switch if, then we're gonna type recurrence equals weekly, comma. And then basically what we're doing here is we're adding extra time to it. So that would be, so weekly, that would mean that we're adding 7 days. So then we'd say due date, tab that over, and then we'd add 7 days after due date. So don't put a comma, just make sure we put slash days, parentheses seven. And then what we'd essentially do is add a comma here. We're gonna basically copy from recurrence to the end of the days section with a comma, and then paste again, and then change this to monthly, and then put 30 days, and then do the same paste here, and change this to yearly, and then do 365 days, and then add a final parentheses at the end. And as you can see, it's already previewing that, for example, task one, 421 would then go to 428, which is a week later. So then I'm gonna set these statuses to incomplete. And then we're basically gonna make a button that would change these from incomplete to complete. So if I go here and put mark as done, then we can make a formula based off of all this. First, I'm gonna change this name to mark as done and put it in a better spot for everyone. So let's actually put it before next due date. And I'm gonna hide everything that isn't really needed. So I'm gonna hide this and this guy and this guy. And then we're basically stuck in a spot where we got this, and we're gonna have to change this button to basically mark it as complete and then recycle everything to change the due date. So let's go into this formula here and go to button options. So we're gonna have to press this formula box. If we wanted to open it up to get a better view of things, we can here. And what we're going to do is essentially tell this button to mark it as complete, and then it would change the due date from there. So what we're going to type in is run actions, add row, this table, add row, recurring tasks, add row tasks, as this is the name of the table, tasks.task, since that is the name of the table and then the specific row from there, then comma, this row dot task, comma, recurring tasks dot recurrence, tasks dot recurrence, comma, this row dot recurrence, comma, tasks dot due date, this row, next due date, then tasks.status. We're gonna do a quote incomplete, and then parentheses, comma, modify rows, this row dot status, and then change this to complete with an extra parentheses in there. So this is gonna do an action. My apologies, I gotta put this row here, and then a comma, and then this row status, and this should clear things up. So then now if I press mark as done, what this did is it basically took example task three. It did a bunch of fancy work to make it so that all of this stuff got moved to the next year. So if I do this, it'll go to April 28th. And if I do this, it'll go to May 21st. So then from here, we're gonna here, we go to columns and we wanna showcase all of these. You can see that we have these old ones as complete. But once again, I couldn't get rid of these different views by hiding them. And then I could filter it so that the status is incomplete, so that anything that's complete, basically, when I do this task and mark it as done, example task three, the original one would disappear, and then the one with the new due date would come forward. If you want to get the template to this, Productive Dude's template is in the description. Give credit to that guy for giving me this great tutorial. So if you guys also want to check out more videos on how to make fancy things happen in productivity apps, click this one right here. You'll have a fun time.